way through Silver Lake here now, just about a half mile ahead. He is going to run into a situation where there is something going on in the right lanes of traffic here that's slowing things down. It looks like a traffic accident right in front of Echo Park here. So things are going to slow down for him just a little bit as he tries to make his way through traffic here. Now, he is kind of in the right lanes of traffic, and that's what's going to be affected in about a quarter mile here. So unless he kind of gets off the freeway or makes his way over to the left lane, only one left lane is going to be open at about Glendale Boulevard here. So let's see what he chooses to do as he comes out from under the overpass. I think he recognizes the slow traffic situation up ahead. And he is now exiting, but sneaks back onto the freeway here. So, boy. Okay, so he is going to put himself right in the middle of a traffic collision that is just about a quarter mile ahead. So being in the right lane, he can still get off. He can still get off right here if he chooses to do so. But if he doesn't, he's going to be stuck in traffic. So my thought is that he is likely going to try and exit the freeway right here. And so we'll see that in the next few seconds here. The CHP is immediately behind this guy, but there is a traffic collision that is blocking the right and the middle lanes just ahead of him. And he is now trying to do his very best to, looks like, get off the freeway. And for him, under these conditions here, that's probably going to be the best thing here for him to continue on. But again, that's going to be the Glendale Boulevard exit south on the 101 freeway here. So as he makes his way over to Temple, we'll see if he crosses through the intersection or makes a left or right turn onto Temple here. We'll know that in just a matter of moments here. It looks like it's going to be a left turn eastbound on Temple. And that is kind of where we are right now. So eastbound on Temple, we're essentially going to be heading over towards the 110 freeway in about a matter of a mile or so. Okay, he's moved southbound. Okay, southbound, and that's going to be over towards the numbered streets, over towards Belmont High School here. So that's kind of where we are right now. And unknown how many people are in this stolen van at this point here, but from what we gather, at least the driver, but unknown if there are any additional passengers in the vehicle. The CHP still kind of tracking along here about half a block back. Only one unit of the CHP is in pursuit, as well as the LAPD airship above. So this is going to be kind of a sweeping left-hand turn as he makes his way over towards 2nd Street. And from 2nd Street, he's going to be near the Belmont Learning Center over towards, say, Beaudry, over towards the 110 freeway. Thank you, Aldo. Over towards Beaudry and over towards the 110 freeway. Bear with me just a second. 5 copies. And that's going to be Beaudry. He's going to make the right turn onto Beaudry there. And at this point, he is going to have perhaps some access to that 110 freeway if he knows his way around here. So if you know the area there, he's kind of paralleling the 110 freeway southbound just on the west side of the street here. So I think my sense is that he's probably trying to look for an entrance onto the 110 freeway here. So we'll kind of watch and see what he does, but again, kind of blowing through some of the slower cars in the area here. It looks like he's going to try and make his way in towards downtown, and that is going to be kind of a difficult situation here because of the buildings here. So we're going to have to make some room here. We're going to climb a little bit to make room for the LAPD airship that needs the airspace up between the buildings here. So bear with us here, but at this point, he is going to be northbound on Figueroa. Okay, thank you. Northbound on Figueroa, over towards, that's going to be 2nd Street, and, okay, he's through 2nd Street, making his way up to Temple. I've got Jolden. Making his way up to Temple. He can still go straight or make a turn if he wishes. At this point, it looks like he's just going to continue northbound. And if he continues northbound, he's going to eventually have access to the 101 freeway if he knows where to turn. Okay, bear with us here, guys. An extremely dangerous situation here, and we understand that they might actually let it go because of the extreme danger to the folks that are on the streets. We're just now going to be coming up on Sunset Boulevard here, and that's going to be the next light that he approaches even as we speak here. It's a red light at that, and it's going to be a right turn on Sunset Boulevard, and at this point he's going to be making his way in towards Chinatown. So that's kind of the direction we're going here. He's paralleling the 101 freeway. He can always, I believe this is going to be that Jack in the Box. Okay, just kind of bear with us here. He kind of blows through the intersection there, and now he's going to be heading in towards Chinatown here. So this is going to be Cesar Chavez, Sunset Boulevard, where it becomes Cesar Chavez, and kind of eastbound. eastbound in towards Chinatown. So not much in the way of traffic ahead of him. In fact, the streets look pretty clear as far as I can see over towards, well, the 10 freeway and the 101. So let's see what he chooses to do here. But at this point, I don't have any units that are immediately behind him. We do have, of course, LAPD airship above that is still tracking the vehicle here. But again, out of an abundance of caution, it appears that they are going to let the ground units have some relief and let them go because of the extreme danger to folks that are on the streets here. So again, they are still tracking them by helicopter. Sky 5 HD also overhead. As we pass by Union Station, we continue Cesar Chavez kind of eastbound over towards the 10 freeway. So that's kind of the direction that we're headed at this point, guys. Let me send it back down to you for a moment. Ooh-wee, going the wrong, oh my gosh, okay. So this is dangerous. This is where it gets dangerous, where you can see kind of the desperation in his style of driving there. I mean, literally, okay, thank you, literally doing anything to avoid having to slow down and stop for, you know, for anyone at that point here. So doing some pretty desperate things here, maneuvering in some desperate ways to just, and the thing is, there's no one behind him. There's no one behind him. It's just an airship above, news helicopter above, and so this guy's still acting this way, as if there are several units directly behind him. And so just an extremely desperate situation for this person, at least in his mind. But as we continue here, we're going to be approaching the 5 freeway in a matter of about a quarter mile or so. But just very dangerous driving situations here where he is on the wrong side of the road, putting people at risk driving, putting people at risk who might be pedestrians on the streets. And even now, as we come up on the 5 freeway, we'll see what he opts to do here. Of course, he does have the option of getting on the freeway, and it looks like he's going to pass right under the 5 freeway here. So again, he's going to be ending up on the other side of the 5 freeway. Bear with us here. It looks like he's going to be in a little bit of traffic there in that white vehicle that's ahead of him. Hang on. Just monitoring at this point. Okay, so PD-10, the airship above, is letting us know, just for information purposes here, that they are just simply monitoring the situation and not necessarily in pursuit at this point. And we can see that because there are no active units that are behind him that are chasing him. And so there's really no direct pressure on this guy, and yet you still see him driving kind of erratically here. So Police 10 is above, and we are just kind of tracking along here as we make our way past County General Hospital. So that's kind of the direction we're going. We're heading over towards Lincoln Park, and that's the direction that we are headed to along Mission Boulevard here, so or Mission Road, I should say. So again, we'll kind of continue to track this stolen vehicle pursuit suspect here as he makes his way over towards Lincoln Park. Guys? Valley Boulevard. Five copies, thank you. Well, it's hard to tell at this point here, guys. A stolen vehicle, it kind of anyone's guess at this point. But just kind of go with the understanding here, guys, that they are not in pursuit of this vehicle at this point here. So they are not in pursuit of this vehicle. They have backed off. They have basically let it go for now. They are still kind of monitoring it from afar, but they are not in direct pursuit of this vehicle here. So we're just going to kind of track along at a higher altitude here, and we're going to hang back for just a little bit and kind of watch where this thing goes here. But Valley Boulevard here now, kind of northeastbound, just passing Rowan Avenue there. But as you can see from our Skyview 5 mapping overlay, just again, Valley Boulevard here. And again, they are not in pursuit of this vehicle any longer. So out of an abundance of caution for the folks that this guy might be directly impacting here. Whether or not there are two people, I have not been able to confirm that, but... Okay, copy that. But just, yeah, kind of go with the understanding that they are not in direct pursuit of this vehicle, and we're just kind of tracking along with this vehicle here. So, yeah, Valley Boulevard here, and just passing Del Paso. And we're just kind of heading in towards northeast, over towards Alhambra, over towards the backside of Cal State LA. That's kind of the direction that we're heading at this point here. So we will continue to follow this, but, yeah, no units directly behind. They are essentially going to be tracking this from afar, and just out of an abundance of caution for the folks, for the public safety here, guys. Okay. Everyone's kind of holding way back, just so you know. Yeah, definitely a turn out and now kind of southbound from Eastern. And so, you know, we're just trying to give them a respectable amount of distance here because law enforcement is just trying to not create a situation where this guy is under too much tremendous pressure, you know, which kind of forces them into a situation where they are driving super erratically there. But you can see they're actually slowing down at this point here. And, okay, it kind of makes you think that they might be soon thinking about foot bailing. But, again, we will kind of watch and see how this kind of unfolds here. But not necessarily driving too erratically at this point, and that is certainly some good news here, slowing down, speeding up, that kind of thing. But, again, that is probably in the favor of law enforcement at this point here because they're not driving too erratically at this point here. Okay, thank you. There may be some sort of a transaction here. It looks like this may be someone he knows. So, yeah, that could be someone that he knows. Sure. Okay. Sheffield at Norwich. Well, yeah, tough to know exactly what's going on here. I mean, exiting the vehicle and now back into the driver's seat here. What looks to be a couple of people there, but okay, reaching in. Okay, Sheffield Drive facing southbound at Norwich Avenue there, and okay. Carrying something that is now going on the grass, and okay, there's certainly an awareness that there are helicopters above, but still acting almost kind of nonchalantly like she's just making a delivery. So who's to say what is going through her mind at this point? But, yeah, there you go. This is going to be southbound Sheffield Avenue right at Norwich and reaching across perhaps for something else. Okay, and there is Alhambra PD. Alhambra PD. Oh, boy. Okay, and they tried to box her in. They tried to box her in. She was not having it, and now the chase is on again. Okay. So that unmarked unit that you saw has pulled over probably to investigate what she was about to drop off there. And now some marked unit, a couple of marked units are now kind of in pursuit again. So they're about half a block back. But kind of moving through this residential area here. Bear with us here. We're getting kind of steep on this thing. She's kind of essentially driving. Yeah, definitely just driving right below us here, so bear with us here. But, again, the chase is now on again. So there, yeah, there is definitely a, you know, okay, I've got you. Thank you for that. Definitely an awareness that she is being tracked and followed. And, you know, as soon as she saw that unit pull right in front of her, she immediately got in the car, hit the gas, and the chase is on again. So Warwick Avenue at Cronus Street. So this is going to be about half a mile north of Cal State LA. It's over in northeast LA, so just to kind of give you an idea of where this thing is going, heading now northbound away. So if we can back off and see if there are units behind, making that left turn kind of westbound, left turn westbound, and just, okay, I've got you there. Yeah, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Alhambra PD seem to be in pursuit here. I'm guessing that's Alhambra PD at this point here, but again, we're kind of running through the residential area at this point here, now kind of making our way westbound slowly through some of these surface streets, but Alhambra PD, 4 units, probably about a block back, and they are, you know, slowly making progress and gaining on her at this point, so kind of what you're seeing here. Not too much in the way of traffic. We have one vehicle, a yellow vehicle, that's up ahead of her that she's going to be kind of having to negotiate around pretty much right now. Uh-oh, okay, head on traffic. Okay, she's got cross traffic coming up right about here, and I think those folks see what's going on here, and so they actually stop before moving into the intersection. Now we're going to be coming up on a major street, and if I'm not mistaken, that's going to be Eastern, and she will have a decision to make north, south, or west. That's going to be northbound on Eastern. Northbound on Eastern now. So heading up towards, say, Huntington Drive at this point here. So just kind of moving through the area here. And, again, a refusal to pull over, stop, and give herself up peacefully. But you saw, I mean, the picture said it all. I mean, as soon as she saw that unit try and box her in, she jumped in the van, and she was taken off as fast as she could. So kind of the theme that we are following along through here. So just out of desperation, it seems like almost, she is now just kind of moving along there. There's Huntington Drive, making that right turn eastbound Huntington from Eastern. And we continue to track this here. So again, looking for units that might be directly behind her. I don't see any units, but we'll try and get into a position where we might be able to. Oh my gosh, look at that. Okay. Pedestrians. And that's exactly why they wanted to give her a little bit of relief in terms of no direct pressure behind her, because she was just driving so desperately, so erratically. And the last thing we need to see is a pedestrian get struck or anything like that on the street by her erratic driving. So at any rate, we're kind of moving eastbound now along Huntington Drive here from Portola. And traffic up ahead, pretty light at this point, so she will be able to kind of negotiate Huntington Drive over in towards the San Gabriel Valley as she chooses, in towards the Alhambra area, guys. Right turn. Yeah, here we go, just kind of parallel Huntington Drive in a pretty narrow alley, and I hope no one's in the alley. Oh my goodness, that is a pretty narrow alley that she's kind of trucking through at this point here. So she's just coming out the exit of the alley, and she's going to make a right turn back towards Huntington. And at Huntington, there's a little bit of traffic heading westbound. She might be just going eastbound at this point, because there's less traffic going in that direction here. So this, she just essentially went around a block here. So just coming up on the light in just a matter of a few yards here, where she actually turned right just a short while ago here. Going to continue along. No, she's going to make that turn. So this may be an area to me that she might be familiar with. I'm just going on a hunch here, but at any rate, she made the right turn over there on Poplar, and she's now in this neighborhood here. So instead of making a right turn into the alley like we just saw her do a couple of minutes ago, she went just to the next street over, and she made the right turn here. So, okay, my sense is that she kind of knows this particular area here. So let's kind of see what happens over the next several minutes here, if we get anyone approaching the van, anyone that she may know. But at this point, she's coming up to the end of the street here, and is she going to make a right turn? Okay, she's going to make the right turn, and the alley that she came through a minute ago is right there. And, of course, Huntington Drive is coming up right now. So, okay, so she's kind of gone around this block twice now. And now she's kind of waiting at that light. So, okay, thank you. So, okay, yeah, indeed, Frank, yeah, now heading westbound, is she on the cell phone? Might have been on the cell phone. Okay, sense that she might have been on the cell phone, so maybe trying to contact someone. She might be close by an area that she knows or is familiar with, but Huntington... Could be. Just now coming up on a red light here. She's going to have to get all the way into the left lane if she needs to get around this red light. And that is what she is doing. She's gone through the intersection. Okay, continuing west along Huntington through Van Horn Avenue at this point here. So kind of heading into a direction that she had just come from a few minutes ago. So kind of heading through the northeast area here in through the Alhambra. area, but okay, I guess we'll just kind of see what she does here. No units that are directly behind her, airships above kind of following along from afar, and now she has just stopped at this red light with no direct pressure behind her. She is just now in a situation where she can actually stop for the red light and not have to worry about units coming up behind her. Okay, I've got you there. Thank you. So, green light, and there she goes, kind of continuing west, and just some unusual behavior, I suppose, but I guess we'll just kind of continue to see how she carries this on here. But another red light, or a stop sign with a pedestrian there. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so that's what kind of worries people, I suppose. You know, the fact that there are pedestrians who are completely unaware that this is happening, and, you know, with the potential of her. Okay, look at this. Pedestrian's going the other way now. Again, completely unaware that the person they're walking right in front of, you know, just moments ago was driving extremely erratically, driving on the wrong side of the road, speeding in and out of lanes, driving erratically on the freeway, just in a desperate attempt to just not be in a situation where she has to give up. So, yeah, just very dangerous. But, again, this is likely the reason why law enforcement decided to back off, so that there is no direct pressure behind her to do any of that and to act in those ways and drive very erratically there. So waiting for the red light, and there she goes now westbound along Huntington, right at Rosemead. So Rosemead Avenue, I should say. Moving into the left turn pocket. Moving into the left turn pocket there. Let's see if that is a move to make a left turn. Maybe not necessarily so. And we just kind of continue along Huntington. So I guess we'll see what she decides to do. Again, at another red light where she is essentially abiding by the rules of the road for now. And that is probably the safest thing that we can think of at this point here, guys. You know, it seems to me that kind of the people who put on pursuits, kind of happens more during the nighttime hours, not so much during the morning, and so we get our fair share, but not a whole lot as you might see on a nightly basis. Okay, hang on, guys. I made that left turn now southbound. Southbound now, if you kind of on the left side of the road, it's going to be mostly residential. She might be slowing up between the trees there, so hang on. Okay, there she goes, right through the trees. On the right side, I can see what looks like some businesses up ahead. There's going to be an elementary school, so kind of still maneuvering kind of southbound along Eastern Avenue here. So we will, or from Eastern, I should say. And so just kind of moving with the flow of traffic here, not necessarily driving too erratically, not too fast, not too slow, just with the flow of traffic. There are cars in front of her. There are cars behind her. And she's just kind of maneuvering as if it was just a normal situation here. So out of the trees, we have one more section of trees once she gets past this stop sign. But at any rate, there are cars in front and behind, so it's not like she's going to be able to charge through unless she gets really aggressive again. So hopefully she doesn't, but that's kind of a look right there. She is kind of looking out the window. Okay, she's seeing someone she knows or something she's familiar with. She's kind of turning the wheel to the left, but okay. Well, continuing south now. Continuing south along Eastern. And we're passing in front of an elementary school. Doesn't look like anyone's there. That's some good news here. We'll be coming up on what looks to be a light, a red light, in just a couple of hundred feet here. So she's going to have to slow down. I don't have anyone, again, still no one that is in direct pursuit of her. And so no units that are immediately behind her. So there's no real pressure for her. So you can see, even though that she seems to be kind of picking up her, you know, weaving and in and out type driving habits, that's what's going on here. So we're just going to track this southbound now, southbound Eastern Avenue, as we make our way over towards, kind of looking up here at Cal State LA, over towards the 10 freeway, ultimately in another mile and a half or so. So we'll kind of track along and see where she takes us here, guys. Whoa, why not? Why not? Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah, don't know what that guy was doing. Okay, now he's made a U-turn. He's made a U-turn. Whoever was blocking that intersection, maybe in an attempt to slow her down, is now okay. Rich, why not just it's okay. So that is the car that is racing up her right side. That car was blocking the intersection as she was coming through. Okay, what are we seeing here, guys? We're just coming up on an intersection here, and she realizes, it seems to me that that car is right behind. Okay, we have units of someone here. Okay, hang on, no. Bear with me here. Okay, that's just a pickup truck. Okay, that one car is now pulling up to the right side of her. So let's see what he attempts to do. I mean, my goodness, okay. Yeah, I don't know. I tend to not believe that law enforcement would have done that, but as we were coming up on that intersection, I could see as they were coming up to it that that vehicle was actually turned sideways in the intersection here to try and get her to slow down. Now she just went right by him, and that's when the person in this darker colored vehicle kind of made a quick U-turn and is now following along here. So maybe in an attempt to get this woman to stop, maybe it's someone that knows the female suspect here. But wow, yeah, this is wild here. Okay, so Valley Boulevard now, guys. Just a heads up, Valley Boulevard now westbound. We'll be coming up on Lincoln Park. We'll be coming up on the backside of County USC Medical Center, just to give you an idea where we are. Ultimately, in another mile and a half to 2 miles, we'll be over towards the 5 freeway. So essentially, we are westbound along Valley Boulevard, heading towards the direction of downtown LA. So yeah, just a weird. Go ahead. I do not see any marked units, Jessica. I do not see any marked units. I only see the one van, and of course a couple of a couple of vehicles that are just normal traffic, and then that one sedan that is still following right behind that white van here. So that white van said to be stolen out of Alhambra, just for what it's worth here. They are the ones that initiated the pursuit. And as you have seen here, CHP had taken over for a time while this thing was on the 10 freeway and on the 101. But now this lady passing Lincoln Park, kind of in a westerly direction, and we'll be coming up on an intersection here shortly. Right. Yeah, anyone's guess as to who might be in that vehicle behind Rich just suggested that maybe it's the owner of the van, but at any rate, it's hard to know at this point. So just coming up on the intersection right now, that's going to be Valley and Mission. Mission going through the intersection, and it looks like she's going to make a hard left. Hard left. Yeah, it looks like the black car is going in the opposite direction, so they're breaking off for whatever reason, but. And now, wow, okay. Yeah, strange happenings, but again, now. I have not seen anything like that, to be honest with you. And in fact, I mean, as that car was pulling up to the right rear quarter panel of that van, I thought he would, in an extreme situation, try and pit the van himself. But of course, that did not play out. And that is certainly some good news here. You want to let the police do their work. They are trained at this. This is what they do. So they have their tactics. And even though we don't necessarily understand it all the time, they know what they're doing, and they are doing it in the best interest of public safety here. So that's what we go by. But yeah, oh my gosh, okay, yeah, okay, Oh my gosh. Okay. Kind of pointing in that direction here, like maybe pull over or. Okay. Oh my gosh. Well, you're seeing the exchange there. You're seeing the exchange here, but hard to make out exactly what's going on in the window there, but oh my goodness. Yeah, hard to know. Oh my gosh. Mission. Okay. Yeah. I think this might be someone else. Just trying to capture with footage or video or photos, but someone just kind of running along there. But this is westbound mission right there at Marengo. And we are essentially near the five freeways. So, you know, it looks like she'll be going underneath the five freeway here shortly. And, popping out essentially on the west side over on the downtown side of the five freeway. So if she makes a left, and she's not going to make the left, that is good news here because that would take us on the five freeway southbound here. So again, just kind of tracking Mission Road westbound. A little bit of traffic ahead of her, but she's going to try and negotiate her way around some of the trucks that are in the truck yard here. So, oh my gosh, okay. Just a tight lane with cars on either side here. So, you know, essentially we're moving back towards downtown LA at this point here. We're going to be moving over towards Union Station and kind of heading in that direction. Now we had come this way, oh, probably about, what, 20, 30 minutes ago here as we were coming through downtown in an eastbound direction heading in towards northeast LA. So, yeah, just to give you an idea, can we widen out the shot, Rich? Can we widen out the shot just a little bit here? We've got that truck yard, that yard, the rail yard over on the right side. And she's just kind of tracking westbound in towards downtown. So we'll be coming up on Cesar Chavez in the next block or so. We're not going to get there because she's going to make the left. Okay. So the left turn will also take her down to Chavez, and that'll be in about half a block or so. And we're moving through a couple of areas of well, there are a couple of salvage yards here. And she is going to have to stop here because we have cross traffic. A big blue truck is going to be right in her way. Right there, so the truck is going to stop, and my guess is that she doesn't have a view of what's going on to her left, so she's going to make the right turn, and again, we're going to be heading over towards Piper Tech, over towards Union Station, in towards Chinatown, along Cesar Chavez here, so she can always make a left or right here along Mission Road, which she was just on a couple of minutes ago. Don't know what she's going to decide to do. She's behind that building there, but let's see, okay, there she is. Going to make the left, okay. If she makes a left, she can get under the freeway there and make a left and exit and enter the southbound 101, if you're familiar with the area here. But if she chooses to go straight, she'll just be pushing into a residential area, kind of a mixed residential and industrial area here. So if she pops out, let's see what she does. Okay, now she's kind of getting herself into a situation where she's going to be, well, not necessarily boxing herself in, but giving herself a few. Giving herself limited options, in other words, here, guys. So we're right next to the LA River, just south of the 101 freeway, so just south of Piper Tech. It's in the back of an industrial area here. Rich, can you widen out just real quick? I don't want her to stop and jump out, but I want to give people a sense of where we are here. Okay, there's going to be a police officer right there, just off her right, and I don't know if he senses what's going on there, but that southbound van against the backdrop of the LA River, the officer is not turning around yet. Okay, now she's making a U-turn. She's making a U-turn, and in front of her, a couple of hundred yards away, is that one officer that she just passed, and now she's behind him, a couple hundred yards away, and the officer, Rich, is going to be a couple hundred yards in front of her. Okay. Yeah, the oh gosh, this is just dangerous for the folks who have to work in this area who may not necessarily know what's going on, but by the looks of it, maybe people coming out, maybe they do know what's going on here. The police officer that she passed is still kind of in his or her vehicle, maybe not sensing what's going on, but she's just driving around in circles here now. It's not like she's trapped. I mean, she can definitely, I can see a couple of ways out, should she choose to, but the way she's kind of meandering around this, okay, now this is a way out for her. Okay, this is a way out. This is one of the ways she can exit the industrial area here. Now she's moving back towards, that's good, that should be Mission Road there. That should be Mission Road. So, okay, here we go. Mission Road, there we go. Right turn, southbound, and for what it's worth, the officer I don't think ever really caught on as to what was happening there, but at any rate, you can see that she, wow, just putting herself in kind of the tightest of situations here. Northbound on Mission Road after making that hairpin U-turn. Northbound on Mission Road, heading up towards essentially the 101 freeway. So, we continue to watch this guy. Stolen vehicle pursuit. Well, not necessarily a pursuit, but more of a tracking situation here where they are not directly behind her, not directly in pursuit of her. But again, northbound coming up on the 101 freeway here in just a matter of a couple of seconds here, guys. Okay, coming up on Chavez. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, at least a situation where she's driving through. This would be kind of the third time along Cesar Chavez, and actually we've just passed Cesar Chavez. We've just passed Cesar Chavez. We're on Mission Road now, and we just passed Cesar Chavez here. So this would be the third time along this stretch of road in particular here. But had a car in front of her, so she had no choice really but to stop. There was no way she was kind of boxed in at that point. Passing a unit of the LAPD right there. But, again, they're not in a situation where they're being asked to engage. They're just kind of letting her be. They're kind of tracking this from a distance here to see, if they, come up on a situation where they might be able to, stop her. But at this point here, we're just going back, back in towards Northeast LA, back towards County USC, back towards Lincoln Park, kind of in that general direction here. In about half a mile, we'll be up to the 5 freeway again. And if she kind of follows through with her trends of the past 45 minutes or so, she might just cross underneath the 5 freeway and head, along Mission Boulevard here or Mission Road, up into Northeast LA again. So we'll know in a matter of just a few seconds whether or not she chooses to hit the freeway or just kind of meander underneath the 5 freeway into in towards Alhambra again, guys. Thanks, Aldo. So it's coming through on Alhambra. Okay. Left turn pocket. Going around. Oof. Oh. Yeah, we do see that occasionally here, and for the police, they feel that it is in the interest of public safety to leave it well enough alone, and so that's what we do. But yeah, that particular pursuit was a CHP pursuit coming through Orange County, and they went on to surface streets in Long Beach before ditching their car by the LA River, and they got a hold of a couple of bikes from a homeless encampment, and at any rate, they were northbound when we last saw them. That was about 3 mornings ago, but occasionally we will see that, and law enforcement, it is their call whether or not they decide to engage. But again, it's going to be in the interest of public safety that they make these calls here. But in that, they know that this particular stolen vehicle suspect, this female here, has been driving along this stretch of Valley Boulevard, along Mission Road, along Cesar Chavez. In anticipation of this, they're far ahead of us in terms of what they're thinking of tactically here. If they are still looking to engage this at some point, they may look to spike strip this person somewhere ahead of the game here. But that is something that they will decide on. But we're talking about Valley Boulevard, Mission Road, Cesar Chavez, and so now we're pulling onto a side street here, and that's going to be, bear with us here, Valley Boulevard here. So, this is what we're going to do here, but again, the police, they kind of know what they're doing, and we leave them to do what they do here. So, right now, like I said, not driving necessarily too erratically here. We're coming up on an industrial section here, and it looks like we have some residences over on the left side of the street here. But we're just kind of making our way back into the northeast area here, Alhambra Avenue, and a couple of cars ahead, a couple of cars behind. No one in direct pursuit of this stolen vehicle suspect here, this female driving this white van. So, no real pressure on her at this point, so she's just kind of leading us on kind of a cruise through Northeast LA, between Northeast LA and downtown LA. But as we move, we're basically paralleling the 10 freeway. We're maybe a quarter mile north of Cal State LA, the backside of Cal State LA at the very least here. So, Alhambra Avenue in towards Alhambra, and this, from what we gather, is where this pursuit initially started well over an hour ago. So, this, in fact, may be an area where she is very familiar with, and so she keeps kind of coming back to the general vicinity here. So if, in fact, she's familiar with the Alhambra area, this is going to be something that she is, essentially going to know like the back of her hand potentially. So, she just made a left turn back westbound in through a residential area here. So, we'll just kind of follow along. She's moving westbound in a position right below the helicopter here, so that's why the shot seems to be getting a little bit vertical here. So we're going to give her a little bit of space. Ooh, she might have stopped there. She looks like she's stopping. We'll try and do our best to. Okay. She's got traffic on either side. It's a narrow street. She just kind of trying to squeeze through there. So that's what's going on there. But she pulls out, now a left turn southbound. And again, just kind of coming through the Alhambra area. This is going to be not too far from the campus of Cal State LA. And she is looking for an exit point here. What do we do next? Is probably what she's thinking here. So, you know, you kind of have to wonder, does she think that she's going to get away or, you know, who knows? So we just kind of follow along and do what we can to kind of monitor the situation here. So. Right, and yeah, we kind of continue here. So now she's basically made a U-turn, and now we're headed back in towards, well, ultimately downtown LA, that area. But kind of moving along here, this is going to be Valley Boulevard, and slowing down. Is she talking to someone there? Is she talking to someone? Does she see someone on this side of the street, Rich? Yeah, okay. Now we might have a couple of more vehicles that are following her. Those two white vehicles that you see there, those two white sedans could be following her. Either encouraging the girl, encouraging her to go on, or perhaps encouraging her to stop and, you know, give it up. But it seems to me those two white sedans may be trying to get involved in some manner here. So, yeah, this. Oh boy. You are exactly right, yeah. Oh my goodness, yeah. And this is what they don't want to see necessarily here. I mean, they have backed off the pursuit for a reason because of, well, the interest in public safety. But, you know, and then we have these two guys who might be involved, and they might be putting some pressure on her, you know, directly or indirectly. But they might be putting some pressure on her. And now, okay, well, look at that. Okay, so let's see. Is there an exchange here? Thanks, Aldo. My goodness, yeah, that's not what you want to see here, but that just kind of complicates things, as you mentioned, guys, for law enforcement here as they try and figure out a way to hopefully eventually see this thing through, but, you know, just a dangerous overall situation. I do have you there. Yikes. So, yeah, when they come up on the left rear quarter like that, to me it seems like they almost want to get it. They almost want to get into a position to pit, but I don't think that's going to be the case. But you never know, especially when they are clearly, you know, kind of involved in some way and moving that close to the vehicle here. So, yeah, who knows? I do have 11. Yeah, I don't know that the motorcycle is in, yes, at least one white sedan, at least one white sedan. Just relaying some information. Okay. Yeah. And there's the second one, we believe. There's the second one. He's got his arms out the window. Okay, so what's going on here? Okay, guys, hang on. Let's see what's going on. There's some sort of an exchange happening here. Okay. Handing out food. Wow. Yeah, who's to say? Oh, my goodness. Okay. Yeah, Rich seems to think that she might have handed off some food or something, but, yeah, just a weird set of circumstances on this one. Yeah, definitely. Okay, speeding up. Okay. Yeah, definitely an increase in speed, a noticeable increase in speed here. So we'll kind of see what happens here over the course of the next several minutes. But yeah, definitely an increase in speed. So we'll see what she is intending to do here. And just tracking behind you there. Okay. Yes, indeed. The police are tracking, and so they do know where this vehicle is. They're relaying, directions, and they're calling out streets and such. But, yeah, so the police are well aware of what is going on here. They're just trying to stay up and out of the way, so as not to put too much direct pressure on this driver here. But everyone is essentially trying to keep a certain amount of distance here so as not to create a situation where she is feeling where she has to drive a little bit more aggressively here. So even now, we're probably about a half mile away as she kind of tracks eastbound, northeastbound along Alhambra Avenue here. So, yeah, we are essentially moving in towards Alhambra here, just on the north side of the tracks, the north side of Valley Boulevard here. So basically about half mile north of Cal State LA. Hang on just a moment. Okay, U-turn. Okay. And what? What was the second part? Okay. Bear with us, guys. We're just trying to get a little bit more information here, guys. We understand she may be under some emotional distress, and so that may play a factor in some of the erratic behavior that we've been witnessing here. So it's kind of thought that one of those white sedans that was following her may be a relative, and is trying to essentially talk her down. But so perhaps a situation where emotional distress is kind of coming to play here, and that may explain some of the erratic behavior that we've seen here. But it's still a dangerous situation that she is putting people in, on the streets here. But okay, she's right behind the tree. Great place to stop. Okay, hang on a moment. Let me see if I can maneuver out. Bear with us. She is just behind that tree there, and she is stopped. So we'll see what she is trying to do at this point here. So, okay. Now moving again. We are in a residential area here off the main street, and now the LAPD has reengaged essentially an airship, at least in a situation where they can monitor what is going on here. So because she is kind of making her way through surface streets here, occasionally driving erratically, when she does get that pressure from behind, it is just a situation where they want to be increasingly cautious and careful. Yes. Yeah, we're getting that sense too. Whoever might be in that dark-colored sedan might also be someone who is known to her or knows her, and maybe trying to encourage her to give up peacefully here. So, yeah, if it's a situation where there's some emotional distress, and, we just want to see this end peacefully, guys, and that would really be the best outcome here. Right now, she's not driving too erratically. You can see her with her elbow out the window. She's kind of looking back and kind of seeing what's going on here. But, My goodness, we just want this to end peacefully, guys. But residential area through the northeast, through Alhambra, turning northbound or heading northbound in this direction. You're not necessarily driving too crazy here, stopping at some of the intersections, but someone trying to cut her off. So a lot of people trying to get involved here. Okay, so this person has a phone, whether he's recording or what have you. Okay. I don't see it, Rich. I don't see it. You got to back off. You got to pull out. Okay. So don't know who that was, but had a camera essentially in her face, but maybe just trying to record her, or maybe, I don't know. But, essentially there are there are a few cars behind her. Whether or not these are all people who actually know her is anyone's guess at this point. I don't have any law enforcement units behind her. So we just kind of continue to track this vehicle here. So making that left turn back westbound here, left turn back westbound. We are definitely in, part of the area here that is, go ahead. Oh boy. Okay, Aldo, I've got you there. Seven, I've got you. Oof. Yeah, that's just, okay, too bad. Missed opportunities on her part to just kind of walk away from this and give up peacefully here and not kind of continue in the way that she has been here. So. And that's sad because now as she accelerates, she's kind of picking up speed, driving a little bit more erratically, and those two vehicles are definitely following her. So they have jumped back in their cars, and now they are within about three or four houses of her as well. So they are definitely tracking her, and I would hope that they are trying to encourage her just to let it go and to just give up at this point here, but. As soon as she gets in that vehicle and she hits the gas, she accelerates and apparently no intention of, giving it up at this point here. But, okay, she's pulled over. Okay, hang on. Okay, door's opening. Hang on, Rich. Okay, the two cars that were tracking her are now behind her, Rich. Okay, okay. Oh, boy, here we go. Okay. You're seeing it, right? Just like we are. Okay, he's going to let her in. He's going to let her in, and he's going to back out, and let's see what this guy does now, because does that make this guy an accessory, potentially? So, there you go. And for what it's worth, that second car is now behind this car, and they are both traveling through the residential street, Gambier at Pueblo. So, the LAPD does have an airship directly above. So, in that sense, they have engaged in a situation where they can keep close track of this situation here. So, there's the one car, and now the silver car, they're going to go straight. So, the silver car isn't going to stick around. The silver car is bailing out. I've got you. Thank you. Okay. So, bear with me here, guys. Okay. Yeah, we're just kind of coming through the neighborhood here. This is purely residential at this point. Purely residential. We're going to be coming up on kind of a main. Okay, stopping. There's another. Okay, the white sedan. That white sedan that we saw earlier is directly behind the vehicle, or was directly behind the vehicle, and ready to pull over. So we might see some more intervention at this point here. So if this person decides to stop. Wow, this is just a weird one, guys. Okay. Howdy Lou, howdy Glenn, good morning to you. We have been tracking a stolen vehicle pursuit for the better part of about an hour or an hour and a half, and just moments ago, the suspect got out of that van, jumped into a secondary vehicle as a passenger. So the suspect in that initial stolen vehicle pursuit has jumped into this Mini and is now a passenger in this Mini. Now, what the intentions are of this driver, who knows, but the driver apparently willingly letting the suspect, the pursuit suspect, into the vehicle here. So they are essentially now traveling traveling through Alhambra and northeast L.A. and have been for the better part of an hour and a half. Now, I don't know if this person ahead of them is trying to box him in or slow him down, but no, he's going to be pulling over to the right, letting that Mini through, and now that Mini is going to be still coming through a residential neighborhood over towards Valley Boulevard here. So we'll kind of track this and see where it goes, but they should be coming up on a, well, kind of a major street here. Well, they're going to make the left. Okay, they're going to stick to the residential area here. He's just made a left turn now eastbound on Ithaca Avenue from Endicott. So kind of where we are right now, not too far from the campus of Cal State LA. And again, perhaps this driver can be considered an accessory at this point here for letting the pursuit suspect into his vehicle, his or her vehicle, I should say. Unknown if this is a male or female, but again, the pursuit just taking some weird turns in that now we have a secondary vehicle here. So I don't believe that the pursuit suspect entered this vehicle giving that driver any direct pressure or anything like that, whether it was a sort of a carjacking type situation. It looks like they were willingly following her, and essentially she pulled the van over and eventually got into the passenger seat of this Mini here. So that's kind of what we're doing right now. We're kind of tracking the Mini here with now two suspects moving back eastbound, so now moving through northeast LA and towards the Alhambra area once again here. So we don't seem to be moving too far out of the immediate vicinity. And so, well, for LAPD and for Alhambra PD, that might be a good thing in that they might be able to predict some of her or some of his maneuvers here and maybe get ahead of it here. So, again, this is something that we are tracking. Okay. Okay, hang on. May have stopped. Okay. Five's going to go to the north side. Seven, I think that's you. I do have you. Okay, although I've got you over on the east side as well. I've got you there. Okay. Five's going to move across your nose right to left. Seven, I do have you, although I have you as well. I've got you, Aldo. Yeah, it's hard to know, but you know, they are definitely taking one person into custody. We believe this might have been the driver of the vehicle here. There is still one person in that Mini, and we believe that's going to be the passenger, the original pursuit suspect here. But she may have gone or jumped into the driver's seat. Now, I don't know that the keys are in there. I don't know that the vehicle is still going, but it looks like they are going to be able to open that door and get her out of the vehicle here. So. Oh my goodness, yeah. What it's just turning out to be a highly unusual police pursuit here. You know, coming certainly to a peaceful end, and maybe in part thanks to the person who picked her up there and put her in a situation where she wasn't able to drive anymore. But again, yeah, just a tough situation here where the law enforcement just didn't give up, and they will be taking her to the rear and, eventually taking her into custody here. So let me see if I can get into a position here. But again, this is a pursuit that started in Alhambra earlier on this morning, a stolen van. And you know, the video that you were watching before where she actually parked the vehicle against the curb there and brought what looked like food out and just placed it on the curb, and then she got back to her van, and that's when Alhambra PD units, an unmarked unit, tried to immediately box her in. Well, unfortunately, she was able to jump into the van and hit the gas and get out of that situation, and that just sparked another whole hour of pursuit here between Northeast LA, Alhambra, and essentially downtown LA. So, some good news here, and you see Hollenbeck Division officers of the LAPD now kind of taking control and taking this person into custody here. We did understand at some point, and it was kind of later on in our coverage here, that she might be under some emotional distress, and so maybe that plays a factor in how she was behaving so erratically. So, you know, hopefully she is going to be okay. Fortunately, no harm, it appears, to any members of the public here. She was driving pretty erratically on surface streets as well as on freeways here. So at times she was kind of weaving in and out of lanes. She was blowing through red lights, blowing through stop signs here. And other times she was just kind of abiding by the rules of the road as the pedestrians were just crossing the crosswalk here. So, yeah, thank goodness it doesn't look like anyone was harmed during this pursuit here, which could have gone very badly here over the course of the past couple of hours. Thank you, Aldo. Over the course of the past couple of hours here. But as you can see, now in custody here, and they're going to be putting her back in the back of that police cruiser here, guys. That is very good news. I got you, bro. Okay. How you doing, Rich? Boy, this was a weird one, huh? My goodness. Okay, five's got you. Thanks, 18. No. Okay, Aldo, I got your back there, bro. Thank you.